Hello everyone, today we'll be taking a look at how we can create a slider in Adobe XD. So first I'll create a rectangular background for my slider. Let me just resize it. Okay, I put it 1200 to 800, and let's put some shadow and give some corner radius. I'll make it 20. Okay, seems good. Now remove the border so like it looks much better, and let's increase the shadow. Okay, so now I'll create another rectangular portion for our slider. This will be the part of actual slider, so I'll just align it to the center, to the background one, and let's add some shadows to it and remove the border. Okay, great. So now let's just reduce the size of the shadow, color of the shadow. Now on the background rectangle, let's add some colors. Let's see what I'll go with, some blue or maybe pink. Oh cool, this okay. Yeah, this seems fine. Great. Yeah, so now let's add a rectangular line which will be representing the actual slider, and let's align it to the center of the screen. Okay, great. Now I'll just resize it so it fits to the center. Okay, I'll just make it even, so yeah, equal space left on both the sides. So I'll align it more to the left, as we'll be going to have a number on the right one. So I'll just remove then make it a light gray shade. Now this seems to work. I'll just increase the like space on the left so it doesn't seem like a compressed one or so. So okay, I just copied it and pasted it on it, and I'll just use color picker and use the same color as a background. So this will be this bar will represent the progress, like the amount of portion which is selected. Now I've created a circle and I'll add some border to it, and which will be of same color as the background. I'm trying different width of border. Okay, so just give me a second. Okay, yeah, this seems good. Okay, let's put it again there and align it to the border. Yeah, great. So now what we need is, initially the progress will be like lesser, like as it, so I'll just reduce it to some level. And I'll just drop the picker, like the thumbnail of the progress to there. Now, let's add the text view, which will represent the numbers changing when we slide these, slide the slider. So I'll use, let's put a dollar sign, and this is how the numbers will be there. So I'll put one by one. So let me zoom in over there. Okay, let's align it first. Fine. Okay, I'll use the font Poppins. I don't know, but I like it. I'll copy and paste it, this one, after changing its color. So yeah, I'll just paste it and let's make it bold. Okay, I'll paste it 3 times as we are going to have a 3-digit number over here. Oh, let's undo this, like let's add some numbers. So oh, it might not be visible as the background and the text has same color, but you'll get to know. I'll change the color later. So I have put from 1 to 0, 1 to 9 and then 0, and change it to black, a dark shade, and I'll align it to the dollar symbol which we have already here. Great. So now I'll just align it first, and then I'll just copy it two more times so we can have a combination of a 3-digit number. Let's align. It seems like overlapping. Great. Now it's aligned. So I'll just change it the initial number to a random number. Like, what should I? Let's make it 126. Okay. Now we want to hide the other number. So what we'll do is we'll create a rectangular box. And I'll just remove the border of it and add some color just so it looks different. And I'll select the three numbers and select this rectangular, and I make a mask of it so only the number behind it will be visible. So we have an initial screen ready. So I used a rectangular before, so let's align it to the center. Okay, it is. Now I'll put this rectangle inside a art box. So like, shortcut is A. I press the A button and then I draw on a artboard. I'll just remove the borders from the background and I'll align it to the artboard so it seems like a full screen thing. And yeah, since the artboard size is changed, and I'll realign it to the center. Great. So we have an initial artboard ready, and I just copied it. What I'll do is I'll change the progress here at to some level, and I'll change the progress bar to the middle of the thumb. Now the ideal in the number should also be changed, so I'll just realign the numbers to some number like okay, this is good. So yeah, what we need to do is our slider is ready. We'll just add the animations from the prototype tab on the left top. We'll click the thumb icon and drag it on the right side artboard. Select the drag option from there. The animation should be auto animate, and we'll select ease in out. Okay, and we'll do the same from artboard 2 to artboard 1. So you know, when we slide from like the more amount to the less, and so it works well in both the case. So let's see how it works. Cool, it's working. So you can see the alert side lights changing the text on the right. So thank you so much for viewing the video. Make sure you hit like, subscribe and comment if you like the video, and let me know what more videos that you want to see in the next upcoming tutorials. Subscribe me on YouTube and follow me on Instagram at nix.uiux. Thanks so much.